few months ago, maybe half a year or more, I shared a blog post on MLOps community Slack about relation, MLOps relation to DevOps. And basically, I had a thesis that we should think about MLOps as an addition to the DevOps stack rather than stack, like kind of independent stack next to DevOps stack that is inspired by DevOps but is independent. And like I'm curious from your perspective. You're in a DevSecOps company, right? How it is how GitLab, at least today, present themselves. So you know you have a lot of DevOps customers and you really understand the processes there. At the same time, you have a lot of experience in data science, in ML, and you're running MLOps initiative at GitLab. What, in your opinion, we are missing in a traditional DevOps stack to support MLOps processes, use cases? What is really missing?
A lot of things. So for me, the difference between the MLOps and DevOps is there is no difference. It's the same thing. It's DevOps is like the art of deploying useful software, and MLOps is the art of deploying useful software that includes machine learning features. That's the difference between two of them. And so this including machine learning features, of course, we cannot fall into the trap as a DevOps company to say that, okay, you can just use DevOps. There are some use cases. There are some specific features necessary for the MLOps workflow that are not present on the traditional software development, I'll call it that way. And that stems from the non-determinism of machine learning. So when you have code, you write the code and you have out inputs and you have outputs. You know the logic. The logic is written. It's over there. You might not know the results eventually, but the logic is there. And on machine learning, you can, some models you can define the logic, but most of them, you can just approximate what it's the logic that is happening over there. They learn from the data. So there's the process of teaching them, of allowing the model to extract the patterns from the data is one part that is not really present on traditional software development. So that's part of kind of like the user or the developer. They are developing the patterns of the input data to the output data. And then there's the other part is how do you know if it is doing what it's supposed to be doing? But to be fair, that is also present on DevOps. That's why you do A/B testing and things like that on regular software. Because even if you know what the output of the change is, it doesn't mean that the users will see that in the same way. So you might, for example, you don't know if it will actually be a better product if you deploy the change that you have it. So you do A/B testing, you do user testing, you do, I don't know. Yes. So that part is also present, but it's even more important for machine learning because it's the only way you know if it's working or not. On regulars or on traditional software, you deploy the change, you at least know that if it is correct. Like you can test if the change is correct, even if you don't know if it moves the metrics or not, but you can test if it is correct or not. But for machine learning, that is the only way usually that you can, like you can implement tests, but tests are non-deterministic. So the regular testing stack that you use as software development don't really apply for machine learning because you're going to have a lot of flaky tests by the definition of machine learning. So your way of determining if that is correct will be in production. You can at most proxy if it works the way you intended to, but you can only know if it actually works the way you intended at the production level. So it puts stresses in different places than traditional software development. It includes everything that traditional software development has, but it puts new stresses on different areas. And to be fair, single way of development puts stresses on somewhere. For example, Android development puts its own stresses on how to develop, on how to deploy. For example, you cannot know what is the version that a user is using. That is a problem that is specific, not specific, but very apparent on mobile development. And ML is another way of another application of this. It will have its own stresses that will require its own tooling.
Okay, but going maybe like talking more on examples, okay? Let's say that we have a like product company, SaaS company that has been so far has been not using machine learning, at least on production level, right? But they are very sophisticated or following the best practices when it comes to software development. So CI/CD, let's say they have GitLab, they have a dedicated SRE team, they have engineering team, DevOps team. They are monitoring their software in production using, let's say, Splunk. Like building the tech stack on the fly, but they are about to release on production two models. One recommender system. Second, it will be, let's say, a chat bot for their documentation and SDK. There are two data science teams, but the ML teams are built of data scientists, so they are not necessarily skilled in MLOps or DevOps. And you have DevOps team. And you're a CTO, what would you do here? Like, shall DevOps team support them in moving it to production? Shall we start from thinking about setting up ML ops team? What would be practical, your recommendation here?
My recommendation doesn't really matter, but what I would potentially do is start with the DevOps team supporting. And identifying within that specific company what are the bottlenecks that the existing DevOps path doesn't support. For example, retraining. But either way, to implement retraining, probably the DevOps team is the best one to work on that. They might not know exactly what a retraining is, but they know how the infrastructure is. They know how everything works over there. It might be that the DevOps team is split if there is enough demand eventually and it becomes a ML platform in itself. But if you don't want to hire anyone, if you don't want to grow if you want to start like we're talking about, start lean, perhaps picking up someone from the DevOps team from the area into supporting your data scientist could be the best way of starting.
And among the customers of the set of customers of GitLab is quite big. So, but let's talk about those you met, okay, personally. Have you seen DevOps engineers or DevOps teams successfully supporting ML teams? Do you see some like common patterns? How do DevOps engineers are like, what is the path for a DevOps engineer to get familiar with MLOps processes and be ready to be called MLOps engineer?
It usually fails when one does something and ships to the other to do their thing. So let's say the data scientist spends a few months doing their model and then I have a model, deploy it. That doesn't work really. They need to be involved early. But that's true for software development as well. So if you say that you're developing something, some new feature, some new service, and then you deploy, you make the entire service, and then you go to DevOps team and say, okay, deploy this thing. That doesn't really work. There are going to be a lot of issues on deploying that software. And there's a lot more stress in this when you talk about machine learning, because fetching data can be slower or there's more processing or I don't know. The model itself can be really heavy, so loading that into memory during run. So it's better if they are at the process, not perhaps not really doing anything, like not really working on it, but at the meetings and discussions, following the issues, following the threads, giving insight before, so that when the model is on a stage that it can be deployed, then it's easier. But for me, it's also important to the model not be the first solution that it's there. So deploy first. It's even if it's a bad one, a bad classical software solution that doesn't perform as well, and then improve. I see machine learning much more as an optimization for most cases than the first solution that you employ to solve that. So, yeah, I've seen it being successful. I've seen also data scientist teams trying to support themselves and succeeding and failing. DevOps teams succeeding and failing at supporting, ML platforms succeeding and failing at support. It will depend on the company culture. It will depend on the people that are on this groups. But communication usually at least makes these problems a little bit less. Involve the people before, not really at the moment you are deploying the thing.
And what is your opinion about these end-to-end machine learning teams, like fully self-service machine learning teams, them being able to manage the entire development and monitoring flow encapsulated in a single team? Because that's what DevOps is about, right? Containing the flow of development in a single team.
I might not be the best person because I'm biased, because I do end-to-end stuff. I like it. I think it reduces the number of hops you have to go. It reduces the number of the communication loss of team to team you have. I like teams that are multidisciplinary, even product, like especially product ones. You have your back end, your front end, your PM, and everybody together. And then you have like you build, you ship, or kind of like mentality that you are responsible for your own DevOps, and then there's a DevOps platform that builds. My opinion, I prefer when they take ownership of end to end, of really going and okay, we're gonna go from talking to the customer of understanding what they needs, even the engineers. I like to see engineers talking to customers. Or our support, all then to deploying the feature, all then to shipping it and measuring it and iterating over it.
And what would be then the composition of this team which would be able to deliver machine learning product end to end?
It will have, of course, its data scientist or a machine learning engineer. Nowadays, I prefer to start more on the software than on the data science part. So a machine learning engineer would be start with the software, then machine learning engineering, then a data scientist eventually to make it even better. For, of course, depending on all the use cases and everything that is involved. But the front end. So start with the feature that you're building, front end, back end, then add your machine learning engineer, then at your data science, machine learning engineer can also do a lot more with the DevOps part as well. The important part is to ship fast, to ship something, even if it's bad in the beginning, and iterate off the something that it's bad, rather than trying to find something that is good and just deploy 6 months later. But at a point, you don't even know if the users want that or not. You deploy a really nice model that no one cares.